Hi guys, welcome to this ESP32 series. Today in this introduction video, we're going to cover what an ESP32 is and why you should use it, how to set up your development environment to allow development of the ESP32, and then finally, together we'll write a basic flashing LED program for the ESP32. Feel free to use the timestamps to jump around the video to wherever you need to go. And without further ado, let's get started. So what is an ESP32? Simply put, an ESP32 is an Arduino microcontroller, but with Wi-Fi and Bluetooth built in. The Arduino and the ESP32 do use different chips, however they can both be programmed through the Arduino IDE that we'll be using today. So why should you use an ESP32 over an Arduino? Well, the addition of Wi-Fi and Bluetooth allows you to add so much more to your project. For example, you can do a web front end to your project to control your microcontroller through a web browser. You can scan your network for different devices. You can connect your device to the cloud, such as AWS, Azure, or Adafruit.io, in order to bring together many devices into one application. Or finally, you can control your microcontroller from your phone through Bluetooth. I'll put a link in the description so that you can order one for yourself. Now let's head over to the computer to get started on our development. Okay, so now that we're at the computer, the first thing we need to do is go to arduino.cc and click to software and downloads. This is where we're going to download the IDE, which is where we do our development for the ESP32. It's the same IDE that you'd use for like an Arduino Uno or an Arduino Nano or something like that. So for download options, you can install the Windows app from the Windows App Store, but I'm going to go to this top option for Windows 7 and newer. Okay, now that it's downloaded, let's click on the installer. Read the terms and conditions, make sure you install the USB drivers. Choose where you want to install it and click install. Okay, now it's come up with a security prompt asking if I want to install these drivers. We need to make sure we do install these as this is how the computer communicates with your Arduino or your ESP32. And with that done, it's installed. So let's open up the Arduino IDE. So now that the Windows IDE has opened up, it's asking us if Java from Arduino is able to access the firewall, then we're just going to allow that. And then coming up here, we'll see Tools in the top left-hand corner, and we click Boards. And we can see all the Arduino boards here, but the ESP32 isn't here yet. Let's go into the settings and add the ESP32 repository, and the board should show up here. Okay, so to add the ESP32 repository to the Arduino IDE, we go File Preferences, and then here you can see the additional board manager URLs. So this URL is going to be in the description, so copy and paste it into your additional URLs. If you've got more than one, then make sure to comma separate them. Okay, with that imported, we're going to click OK. Okay, so if we go to Tools, we can click on the board and then the board manager. And it's going to download the additional ESP32 boards. So if we now search for ESP32, we can choose the version we want and then we can install these. So this will allow the code we write in the Arduino IDE to be compiled for the ESP32 boards that we're going to be using. Now that's done, when you're in the board manager, when looking at ESP32, you'll see it's installed. If you close that and go back to your tools and click boards, you're going to have your Arduino boards that you used to have, but you're also going to have the ESP32 boards. And here you can see all the different types of ESP32 development kits you can use. So with that set up, let's now get the ESP32 out, wire it up, and write some code for it. Okay, so the project we're going to be doing today is just a really simple ESP32 flashing LED. So for this, you're going to, of course, need the ESP32. You're going to need two jumper cables to connect the ESP32 to the LED into the resistor. For this, I'm going to use a breadboard, or you could solder this, but a breadboard's going to make it much easier. And then you're going to need an LED and also a resistor. For this, I'm using a 220 ohm resistor. Okay, so now I'm going to tell you how to set up the circuit. On screen, you can now see the circuit diagram, which is going to be easier to follow to set this up rather than trying to look at this breadboard. But we're going to have the ground cable, so for me this black cable, joining to the cathode of the LED, which is the small leg. Then the long leg, the anode, is going to be connected to this resistor, for me 220 ohms. and then the resistor is then connected to the red wire, which will then be joined to pin number D18, or it might just be pin 18 on your ESP32. So with the ESP32 unplugged from the circuit, let's plug it into our computer with a USB cable. Now that I'm back at the computer, I'm going to plug my ESP32, see if it can focus there, into my computer through a USB cable. With that connected, we can now start writing our code. So what I've done here is set a constant, which means a variable that isn't going to change, of type integer, which just means a whole number, and I've called it LED pin, and then I've set the value of it to number 18, which is because I'm going to use pin number 18 on my ESP32. If you don't have a pin 18 or you'd like to use another pin, then feel free to change that to another digital pin. So on mine, they're represented by the D in front of the number. So for me, this is D18. So I'm using LED pin number 18. If you haven't seen an Arduino or an ESP32 script before, there's two main sections, your setup section and then your loop section. Your setup section happens as soon as your ESP32 turns on, and this usually only happens once. Once that's set up, your loop section just keeps looping around the code in this section forever until the ESP32 is turned off or there's an error. So in our setup section, we need to tell the ESP32 that we want to use pin 18 as a digital output pin. So by writing pin mode, open brackets, LED pin, comma, output in all block capitals, close brackets and semicolon. This is telling the compiler that we need to set up pin number 18 as a digital output pin. One thing to note is the Arduino IDE in this programming language is case sensitive. So if I put a capital M for mode, then you need to make sure to do that too. So now that's it for the setup section. All we need it to do when it turns on is set up that pin. Now the looping section, this is where we're going to turn that LED on and off again. The first line, digital write LED pin high. This is just going to send a high signal to that pin, which will turn the LED on. We can now use the delay method to delay for half a second. As you can see here, I've done 500. This is because the delay method uses milliseconds, and there's 1,000 milliseconds in a second. So now that we've written it high and then we've delayed, we can copy these two and paste them below and then change this high to low. So what we can see it's going to be doing is setting that LED to on or high, waiting, turning it to low, and then waiting again. And that's it for the code. Like I said, this is really simple to begin with, but in the future episodes, we're going to be doing much more complex things, making use of the Wi-Fi and potentially the Bluetooth as well that's built into the ESP32. Now with the code written, we need to tell the Arduino IDE that this code is for an ESP32. So if we come to this Tools tab, then under the board, we can go to ESP32 Arduino and ESP32 Dev Module. Clicking on Tools again, we can leave the upload speed and the frequencies all the same, but we do need to come down to this port. As you can see, I've got two ports here, 1 and 3. If I don't know which one my Arduino is connected to, I can open up Device Manager, come to the port section here and expand it. And as you can see, I've got 1 and 3. So if I just unplug my ESP32 from my computer, we can see that communication port 3 has disappeared. So plugging it back in again, I know that I need to tell the Arduino IDE that my ESP32 is on port number 3. So let me close Device Manager and come back into the tool section and tell it to connect to port 3. And now I'm ready to check over my code. To do this, I can click the verify icon, just this little tick in the top left corner. And this will just compile the code and make sure that everything looks okay before we push it to the ESP32. And as you can see, it says done compiling. If you've got any errors or issues, they'll come down here, usually in orange text. So with the code checked and it's all okay, we're ready to push it to the microcontroller. So to do that, click this forward arrow or the upload icon. And it's going to compile the code again. And we can see in this output window, it's trying to connect to our ESP32. For you, this might disappear and connect without issues. But for me, for my microcontroller, I've got to hold down the boot button. And as you can see, the connecting sequence has stopped. And now that all this text down here saying it's written, I can let go of the button. Now at the bottom, it's saying leaving and hard resetting via the reset pin. So that's it, the code's uploaded to the ESP32. I can now safely unplug it from my computer and we can go over to our circuit and plug it in there. So we're now ready to plug it into the circuit. So to do this, the black pin is going to go to one of the ground pins on our ESP32, and then the red cable is going to go to pin 18. And now we're ready to plug our ESP32 into power. So for me, I'm going to plug the USB port back into a computer or into a wall brick to get power to the ESP32 to see the LED start flashing. With the USB cable plugged in, we can now see the LED is flashing on and off. Okay, that's it. You've got your ESP32 flashing an LED. I know that's a very basic project, but stay tuned for more complex videos where we'll cover the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth that's built into the ESP32. If you've got any issues with this project, or you've got any ideas of things you'd like me to cover in future videos, whether that's for the Raspberry Pi or the ESP32, put that in the comments below. And if you like this video, then like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.